Okay, so it's the 15th of August and the time is 12:54. I'm currently in Dublin because I'm picking a friend up from the airport, a friend who I haven't seen for a very long time.
How's it going, fam?
It's a long time no see.
This is nice, this.
Oh,
we're not even at the same way. How are you?
All good. All good.
I fell asleep for the full flight. Felt like it was on for 2 seconds.
Good. Some woman's coming to move us because we've been here for a while.
Have you?
So, here he is, the man himself.
Here I am.
It's been a long time.
In the wagon. These cargoes, I'm hoping that I can get one of these very, very soon.
Actually, the last time we were in a very similar car, Adam's Defender. This and the Defender both drive like tractors.
Look cool, though. Cool. Yeah, Instagram right. Worthy, though.
And also, the last time me and Adam were together, we were eating really bad food.
Thank you.
Cheers, mate. See you later.
This is great. I'm just going to park over here, straight ahead.
But this time, I've got donuts. So we've got a lemon donut and we've got a peach donut. And we're going to share them for our pre-workout.
We're going to share.
It's going to be nice. And then we're going to get a workout in, which I'm going to film. And I'm going to film it nicely.
I want to try. Where is it? This bad stuff, because I've been wanting to try it for ages, but I've not seen anybody with it. Trust Louis to have it, because he's got all the gear, no idea.
And we've got this as well. We've got that flavour. So, and then we've also got...
This is the best stuff. Where is it?
2 seconds. This is the best. Pump. The best supplement I've ever took in my life.
Yeah. I've seen Christian Guzman's videos far too many times and wanted to try this stuff. So I'm just going to concoct this and just see what happens.
So now... I've got the big gun out. And we're going to film sick workout in Rob Lipsett's gym. And we're going to take lots of pre-workout.
If I can remember how to work out.
If Adam can remember how to work out.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's going to be good.
And then we'll catch you. Quite cool in matching tops, don't I, as well?
Oh, and he's representing as well.
Represent?
Sick lads, that's why. All the way back to Hollister days, you know.
Yeah, it is. Maybe all the day one. We live a stereo life, you are my frequency. We got a physical vibe. We're a little bit on a caffeine, like, I don't even know what to call it. It's a bit, we're riding the wave. The wave is very, very high right now. We've had a lot, and now I think we need to eat, because we've been in the gym for probably about 3 hours, which was meant to be an hour and a half. But got some sick pictures, got pictures with people. Yeah, so I'm going to buy Louis Nando's because he's came about... God knows how many hours.
2 hours. Yeah. 2 hours. Not too bad.
Not too bad. What should we do for the vlog? Should we try and film a Q&A? I may put a Q&A on my story and see if people... Yeah, I'm going to put a Q&A on my story, a Love Island related one, and see if people want to ask some questions and keep all the fitness ones for a different video.
What we're going to do is we're going to combine footage and we're going to make a vlog for Adam's channel because it's been too long. And we're going to make a vlog for my channel because it's also been too long. And just combine them, make them a little bit different, and I'm gonna upload it to Adam's channel and he's not gonna upload it to my channel, but I'll upload my channel as well. So let's just see how this day goes. This isn't the most flattering lighting on me, but Adam looks very sexy, so it's quite annoying.
I'm actually looking alright. I don't know what's happened to my hair. I've been butchered by some barbers, but I mean, we're all right, we're all good, we're happy, we're healthy, and we're living life, and we're gonna go and get, I might even have hummus. You might even what? Have hummus.
Hummus.
Might go out.
Might as well.
Go all out. Hummus and hummus.
Right.
Oh, there he is.
Drizzled onion.
Yeah.
Right. This
do you always get hummus?
Yeah. Always hummus. I've got a hummus at home. It's like a bit of an addiction. I went through a phase coming in and just getting two hummuses.
You've got to get your knife. You've got to like create a little crevice, a little hole. It's a little bit of a hummus moat, like a castle. You've got to get your crevices open and plant it in the center. But you don't use all of it once, you save a little bit because you always put a little bit at the end. So you're just going to.
T-minus 22. Where are we?
We are in Tullamore, in a pretty cool hotel, to be fair. It looks a bit like Titanic, but obviously not on water.
Can we take a picture? Do you mind?
You want me to
yeah, that's no problem.
No.
Hey, I've got loads of stuff, sorry.
Right, do you want the flash on this one? Might as well. Right, ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, that's lovely.
Thank you.
No problem. So, me and Adam are sharing a bed. He did get given two rooms, but he kindly gave one away.
I gave one away to young Connor, who is taking us about tonight, because he seemed like a great guy, seemed like he was a little bit tired. Told him to have a nap before he takes us at 9 o'clock, and it is about 7:15 right now. So we are going to get ready. We're going to film a Q&A. Am I right?
It's a tight ship.
Tight ship. And then, yeah, just get vibing.
This is our room. What do you think of that, Adam?
It'll do. It's decent. It'll do. It'll do.
We need to get pints and do a Q&A. So,
I need to charge my phone.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna swap to the other camera, and when I swap, we'll be in the Q&A. Okay, so this is a vlog that me and Adam are doing between us. Don't know how it's gonna be different on both of our channels. Maybe it'll just go on Adam's channel, and maybe I'll just put a few previews in my YouTube. We'll just see what happens.
We're gonna see what happens. Hopefully it flows, and then we can get two sick videos out of it. But if not, at least we've got two sick Guinnesses out of it.
This is the first time I've been in Ireland with Adam, and we're in literally the middle of nowhere. It's took us an hour and a half to get here from Dublin. How does that first sip taste?
I don't know, you know.
No, it's a good Guinness. Adam doesn't really like Guinness, but that's a good Guinness. I know it's a good Guinness because
it's got an aftertaste, something. You can taste like the iron.
Yeah, it's good for you. Good. And it's also extremely hot. We've jammed the window open with a bin.
Yeah.
The shower was like a million degrees, and yeah, it's hot, so we're gonna get sweaty in here.
And the hairdryer is older than my grandma.
Oh, the hairdryer, Jesus.
Louise had a mare.
I've went to borrow a hairdryer from the reception, and they don't have one. She recommended using the one in the room. I'll show you the one in the room in a sec. What we did was we put out a question box on Instagram on Adam's.
Yeah, should we get it up?
How many views has it got?
So the views it has got...
We put it up about an hour ago, and let's see.
67,000 views. 68,000 views, and
how many responses?
Where's it tell you how many responses?
Don't know. Go on, just click see all. I'll show you right, I'll show you on this camera how many responses.
So
hold on. Right, scroll through them fast.
It will just keep updating.
Phone? 1 second.
That is the phone for the hairdryer. The hairdryer was really, really shit. And he's really...
Hello?
Desperate for this thing.
Honestly, don't worry about that. Adam's managed to dry my hair for me, so it's all good.
Bye. Yeah,
not that's perfect.
My mouth. I've just
thank you. Bye.
Obviously, Louis making his first appearance for me. It's Louis' first PA, so obviously he is now wanting to do himself up a little bit. That's why he's got a funky shirt on.
So now you can see the hair is a dead thing, but we're going to deal with that. Right, so we're not using this camera. We're just using this camera to show the questions.
Yeah.
So let's dig in. We haven't looked at any of the questions. We're just going to go through them. If they're appropriate, they're appropriate. If they're not, they're not. We'll have a bit of a laugh about it. I also put out some questions, so I'm going to answer some questions from my followers too. Mm. So, should be good. Let's get into this. Do you wish you had stayed longer?
No, I don't, because I think, obviously with the whole Zara thing and Zara leaving, I tried to maybe, I convinced myself, as well as other people in the villa, who were friends of mine, convinced me that I might have been a bit rash if I left then. And obviously bringing Daryl back to the villa after that was probably a mistake. Not Daryl's class, like Daryl has literally been more sound than ever. But I was ready to go, because once Zara had gone, and then once I brought Daryl back and came back to the main villa instead of Casa Amor, it makes you realise like your feelings, and it is like all your feelings are like heightened when you're in there. So I think I was definitely ready to go. I'm glad I didn't leave it too long for like getting back and seeing Zara and stuff like that.
I think you did the right thing.
Yeah.
Right, next question. Fave moment in the villa.
So I've got a couple. There was the one where so on Josh's birthday, it was like super emotional, and there's you wouldn't have really seen how emotional it was because it was the dancing scene, the slow motion camera, but we, all the boys, were like hugging arm in arm, and like literally it was so emotional and it was sick, and we were like, how are we here, how is this like a thing that we're doing, and like how sick is it gonna be when we get out. It was Josh's birthday night. Another one was probably the night I recoupled with Zara, or the when we won sports day.
Were there staff cleaning, cooking for you in the villa? Are you allowed to answer that or not?
Yeah, when, you can answer
well,
that.
So. What I'll do as well is I'll add on to that, because I was curious to know whether Adam had been, like, it was obvious as the viewer to see that they had been getting their hair cut. Danny's hair colour changed altogether at one point, and I just asked Adam, like, was there someone in there cutting your hair like every day or whenever you wanted? So I think that ties in with the cooking and cleaning in the villa.
So cooking, we cooked breakfast, and lunch and dinner was cooked and brought out in like trays, and it was like a variety of everything. So like you had some like chicken breast and fish, which was quite nice, and then you had proper like chicken nuggets on the other end, so that was like quite good.
Healthy, a good balance.
Yeah, and then they put like certain stuff in the fridge for if you just like want a snack. Then what was the other bit? The hair.
Cleaning.
Towels. People came in and make the beds, but I probably guessed that as well. Some of the stuff was timed when we were out doing challenges, so it was quite good. Haircuts. I think I had one haircut when I was there, but also Laura was cutting hair quite a lot, and Wes and Josh were cutting hair a lot. So if you just wanted the sides done, like they were doing that.
Did you ever have your hair cut by Josh or Wes?
No, I had my eyebrows done by Wes. I didn't let him cut my hair in the end, because the day we were going to, a woman came in and cut my hair anyway.
Safe.
So that was like one day, and I was in for 5 weeks exactly. But
hair
as well,
good. Hair looked good. Considered.
But you get like clothing drops as well.
Oh, do
you? A little sack. So there's like a little Santa sack, like just a laundry bag.
Yeah.
And everybody gets clothes off like Menace on the
Fresh new clothes.
Fresh new clothes. So that's pretty sick. Like that was awesome. I think I got 3 in 5 weeks. So
what?
I'm guessing if you manage to stay at the end, you probably got 4.
That's unreal. Yeah. So you always have fresh clothes.
Yeah. It's pretty nice.
Next question.
Oh, are you single?
Yeah, a lot of people keep coming up to Adam asking if he's single, but I can't figure out that why people are saying that, because in all of Adam's Instagram stories, he has been with Zara, but I don't know why people keep asking.
No, I think basically that Zara's right now in Bulgaria on holiday, and for it's probably the first 4 or 5, maybe even a week that we haven't spent with each other, and apart from that, we've been together constantly, so I think everyone's like, oh my god, like everything.
Just because
like,
you've had just 5 days away.
Just because I've had 5 days. I'm in a hotel room with one of my mates filming this, and people are like, straight away, they're like, oh, he's not with Zara, so they must have broke up, which is ridiculous, because how can you spend 24 hours a day with your bird, especially when I'm doing events all over?
Also quite annoying that people assume that. This is what someone else asked you as well. What UK food did you miss? So is there any food that you missed specifically that you couldn't have in the villa?
Nando's, obviously, because I absolutely love it. And sushi. Yeah, that was it. The food is pretty good and it was pretty healthy, and I eat most of the stuff that was there all the time. Like, the chefs were pretty good, to be fair. Not that we ever saw them, but they must have been pretty good. Sushi, though, definitely.
Nice.
Oh my god, how I forgot this. Diet Coke, fizzy drinks. Fizzy drink.
You
we weren't
no
allowed
fizzy drinks.
We had fizzy drinks one day, because they let us have like a cheat day one day.
What?
So this one day we were like, oh, and they brought in burgers, chips, and fizzy Diet Coke, and I'm not kidding, everyone went mental. Like, I even said to them one night, I was like, I will trade my alcohol in for like 4 Diet Cokes. Like, I'm, if anybody knows me, I smashed so many Diet Cokes and like Monster Energy as well. Like, that would have been amazing. Did I miss that?
That's a good one. Are you allowed to talk about how you only allowed limited alcohol?
Yeah.
I guessed and I presumed that their alcohol intake per night was limited, and Adam answered that quite clearly to me and said that they were allowed what?
So it was 2 glasses of wine
or
4 mini San Miguels. So basically 2 San Miguel beers were like the equivalent of 1 red, white or rosé wine or 1 champagne. So I think I had beers a couple of nights and I had 2 glasses of red wine because that's the only one I like.
And plus that probably gets your alcohol levels up.
Yeah, probably a little bit better, innit? Red wine.
If you're from Newcastle, you want to get your alcohol levels as high as possible.
Yeah, so you want the sauce. I think I was drinking the mouthwash by the end to try and get a bit of a buzz.
Do you get to go on trips outside the villa on the Saturday that there isn't a new episode?
No, to be honest, you forget what day it is. Like, Josh forgot his own birthday. He really did. Someone actually had, I think he was with Georgia at the time, and Georgia woke up and Georgia actually went and like did something for his birthday, like made him breakfast in bed or something, or made him a cake maybe, and Georgia had to remind Josh it was his birthday because he didn't realise, and he actually had to think about how many days he'd been in to work out if it was or it wasn't, because he couldn't answer the question. So that's, you don't insane. Really know. And obviously on the episode, some of them might cut on at the end of a night and then follow on from the later on in the night the next day if something dramatic happens. So you might not know when it's a Saturday, but yeah.
That's
we didn't go on trips.
No.
Didn't go on trips.
Oh, you got to play sports.
Yeah, I've got to play sports.
Games, fun and games with the couples. Any regrets of your decisions in the villa with the woman you've decoupled with or recoupled with? Doesn't really make sense, but like, any regrets with choosing girls, not choosing girls?
Not really, you know. Like, I think I'm a massive believer in, like, everything happens for a reason. And I'm now with Zara. I'm now happy. And life is ridiculously good right now. Like, I have so much, without trying to, like, be cocky or, like, I've got so many good opportunities right now. And I've got a min family. I've got min friends. And, like, Zara. And, like, why would I not want that happened now? Maybe it would have been different if I tried to, like, maybe it would have been different and there wouldn't been as much opportunities for me if I played it safe, and I was never gonna play it safe.
Nah, it's not you.
No, it's not me.
Why would you try and be different? Like, why would you not be yourself?
Yeah.
Who the hell wants to play it safe?
Yeah.
Never play it safe. Did you know Zara was the one when you met her?
It was definitely, I would say 95%. I just had to make sure. Like, but I would say as soon as she walked in, I knew that it was different, and I knew that it was going to cause a hell of a lot of drama because I wanted it so bad. I wasn't going to let anybody else get Zara at that point.
Why did you decide to go on Love Island? Did you go on for the crack? Did you go on for the love? Did you go on to boost your social media following? What was it? Why did you go on?
This is a funny one, right? Because everybody comes in, when all the bombshells come in, everyone always sits down and they say, what do you do? What is your type? Who do you fancy out of the girls here? And did you come in a Love Island to find love? And everyone's like, yeah, I came in to find love, right? I came in and I was like, I'm not really bothered. I came in to have a laugh. I came in because I think I'll be good. Came in probably because I wanted the limelight a little bit. Who doesn't? And not for that. Just because I thought it would be good to put myself in an environment that I've never experienced before. Not because I wanted Instagram followers. I just thought, why would I not want to go in a villa for a few weeks and see what happens? Like, you never know until you try it. And if someone rang me up, which they did, and said, do you want to come on Love Island? And I said, no. Would I regret the decision of saying no for the rest of my life? Zara was a bonus, and Zara really, she was a massive bonus, and it's great. But at the same time, like, did I expect to find her? Probably not. But no. As soon as she walked in, yeah, massive bonus.
Yeah, it's sick. But it's double win.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's unreal. Face ID. Also, you can't see it on that camera, but I'm going to show you. This is Adam's screensaver on his phone.
Right,
last question. And then I'll do 2 off my phone. How did you know that you were going into the villa after you applied? Like, how did you find out? I know you just said you got a phone call, but when did you apply? How long did it take them to get back to you? And when did you get the phone call?
So I didn't apply.
What?
I did not apply for Love Island. I met a guy when I was 19, and he was in Newcastle in a bar. and he came up to me and was like, do you want to be on Geordie Shore? Because at the time he was a casting agent for Geordie Shore and didn't end up going on Geordie Shore. And he then, obviously further down the line, had a drink with him, made friends with him, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, he then turned into one of the biggest casters in Love Island. And he rang me up, he Instagram DM'd me saying, can I ring you? And he rang me and said, have you finished with your ex-girlfriend? And I was like, yeah, like 4 or 5 months ago, something like that. And he was like, you need to come to London now. And it was about Love Island. And I went in the ITV studios and had a couple of interviews, and then that was it. And I think that was maybe like 3-4 weeks before. 4 weeks before, I think.
That's insane.
Maybe 5 at a push, but it wasn't like a massively long time before that. And then I just trained ridiculously before that.
Adam was on this really strict diet, and literally, I would say probably, how many people knew that you were going in the villa?
My dad, my stepmom, Lewis, who helps us at the gym, and my best mate, Matty, and my best female mate, Eden.
Because I had no idea, and I was like, why is he getting so shredded? Like, he was literally going in the gym, like, he works in a gym, but he was, like, also training himself, like, 4 times a day, and I was like, where is he going and what is he doing? Like, I don't understand.
It was funny because there's quite a lot of people who were saying like, God, have you seen Louis' pain compared to mine?
You need to get on it.
So many people were going, why are you training so hard at the minute? I was like, nah, I don't know, I just fancy it. Not at all. There was morning routines and there was nighttime routines.
Final question. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? And what are you going to do to stay on top of the game? To stay relevant and to stay in the public eye and to keep people's attention on you?
It's probably a couple of things that I want to do. I like the whole Instagram photography, doing cool videos, doing YouTube stuff like this. So obviously for me, I don't really know where I'm going to be in the world tomorrow or next week right now. Like, I have a little bit of a schedule, but there is things that can change all the time right now because I'm so in the limelight and all of the Love Islanders are. So if I have a computer and a camera, I can work online coaching for fitness anywhere in the world. And I really want to try and get people into fitness. I want to help people that have been in a little bit and not seen any results. And then I want to help the super advanced as well. And I think I can try and hit every one of those levels as I go along with time.
Definitely.
YouTube would definitely be a good thing. And like, I'm passionate about fashion as well. Like, I would want to, like, if you noticed, I'm not the smartest person in the world with what I wore on Love Island, but like, I know what I like and stuff like this. And maybe if I can bring something like that, maybe an edgy sport brand, or maybe just something that I would wear as a lifestyle brand. We've spoken about this a million times, and see where things go. And then,
you say?
I mean,
do everything you want to do.
Get a house somewhere, travel a little bit more, have some fun, take some cool photos, and then maybe marry Zara if she's lucky. And then have plenty more Guinnesses, even though I hate them, with this boy.
He's gonna have to finish that. We've had a really good day. I've had a sick day.
It's been a sick day, definitely.
And yeah, we're gonna have a sick night now. Yeah. Gonna neck our pints and go and end the vlog here, and you'll see this on my channel and Adam's channel.
And yeah, I mean, hopefully this is going to get the ball rolling for me, because I had a mental week last week, but it was probably my last major crazy one apart from a little bit in September, and I'm going to try and keep this up.
Yeah, leave a thumbs up if you think Adam should get back on the YouTube, and comment down below what you want to see more of, and I'm going to get him sorted. I'm going to push him into it, whether he likes it or not,
yeah.
And we're going to be putting out content, so
I'm going to come to the island and get some class vlogs.
And lots of Guinness, right?
Yes.
Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next one.